Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Signal Processing Programming on MATLAB software. So it is lecture number 3rd. Initially in lecture number 1st and 2nd we learn about the basics thing about the software, MATLAB software. Now I will continue the same topic. Now in lecture 3 we are going to learn how to creating the vectors and arrays. So in MATLAB programming it's very important to make the operation on the vectors and array. So initially is nothing but matrix. So first thing, when we want to make some array, for example from 0 to 6, so there is no need to write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 like that. So this is one case. For example, a is equal to initial value colon increment colon final value, means if you want to start with 0 with increment of sum, here I have taken example 2 up to final value 6. So it will declare 0 increment 2, again increment 2 means 4, again increment means final value 6. This is the one thing. Second, if you want only the final and initial value, then you can write initial value colon final value, that is a equal to 0 as to 4, means it will display the all the values from 0 to 4. Then there is another one command, line space, linearly space vector. That is, for example, here I have defined one variable x equal to line space is the command, in bracket first comma last comma n. Now here we can declare first value, again last value with the increment of n. So you can see here example, line space 0 comma 20 comma 5, the initial value or the first value is a 0, last value is a 20, and n is nothing but increment with the 5. So its values become 0, 5, 10, 15 and 20. In same way, there is another one command, that is a log space, logarithmically space vector. Again the same variable I have declared, x equal to log space, here first, last and n. Again the same, log space 0 comma 3 comma 4. But this is a log space, so you can't directly take these values. First you have to find out the log. So what is the 10 raised to log space a b n? A is nothing but first value, b is nothing but last value, and n is nothing but increment value. So when we take 0 as the initial value, so 0 as the initial value, then 10 raised to 0 become 0, 10 raised to 0 become 1, log of 10 raised to 0, log of 0 is 1. So that's why the initial value is 1. So like that you can find out the all these values. So you can take example, for example if I copy this example on MATLAB software, just I will do on the command window only. So you will get 0, 2, 4, 6. In same way, if I take a equal to 0.4, so it will display 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so like that you can check. Now next thing, already we learned how to make a rows, how to make a matrix. But suppose if you want to transpose means what? If you want to convert row into column and column into row, in that case what is the command? So here I have taken one example, for example this is a matrix. Okay, so this is a matrix, already we learned how to make a matrix. So here is the transpose command, y equal to x dot dash, or you can also write x dash. So what will define? It will transpose the x matrix into the column. For example, I will take x equal to all this value. Just direct I can take one example, x equal to in square bracket 1, 2, 4, 1, 2, 5, 7. So this is a row. Then I will take y equal to x dot dash. So you will get column. So this is nothing but transpose of this matrix. Sometimes you can also take x dash also. Okay, so there are two ways. You can take x dot dash or you can take x dash. Then arrays and matrix, again the same case what we learn in first in 5 minutes before, that is x equal to 1:5, so it will display value from 1 to 5, the transpose of matrix, all these things. Now if you want to select some particular value, then how to select? So it will define y equal to x2 comma 3 means row number second, column number third, that particular value is nothing but y equal to 4. So directly you can take, if you want to select whole row, in that case you can take whole row, that is y equal to x 3 comma colon, so it will select all row number 3. Suppose you want to select column, particular column, so colon comma 2, so it will select the column number second from the matrix. So we can take example, then you can understand very well. Suppose I can even take one example. So first of all I will clear this command. Suppose a equal to in square bracket 1, 2, 3 like this, 4, 5, 6, colon, 5, 7, sorry, 8, 9, 7. So this is the matrix. Now if I want to select this value, then how I can write? I can write a, sorry, I can select one variable b equal to a in bracket. So if I want to select this value, in that case first you have to select in which row, is it 1 to second row, colon, sorry, not a colon, comma, and this is second row and third, sorry, second column. So you can write, just you can give the enter, you can get value 5. If you have to select whole row, row number first, then suppose n equal to, one is nothing but row number first, colon, comma, colon, it will select all the values, row number first. Now if I want to select column number first, then just you have to reverse. So it will display 148, so is 148. Like that you can select a particular whole column or particular whole row. Now here I have taken some example. If you want to select the 2, 3 values from the matrix, then you can take the a 2 colon 3 comma colon. So initially it will define the row and it will define the column, means before the comma all the rows and after the comma is a column. So what will define 2 colon 3 means it will select the row number second and third. Okay, here you can take example. Once again I have taken that matrix. Suppose I can take L equal to A as 2 in bracket. Suppose if you want to select 0 number 2 and 3, so just I can write 2 colon third comma colon, so you will get 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 7. In same way you can, there is another way to select that particular values. Here 2 comma 3 means second row, column number first, then second row, column number third, means all the values from 2 to 3 rows and all the values from column number first to 3. So you can write here, suppose 2 to 3 means all the values from row number 2 to 3. Okay, and now means the row number second and first column also. Okay, so it will define 1 colon 3. Again the same case. Okay, so there is another way to select the particular column or vector. Okay, now again there are different examples are there, the same examples are there. Again there are different ways to select the values. For example, I have taken one example, just I will copy this example. First I will clear this. This is one of the matrix, sorry, just I have defined the semicolon. So in command window, if we take the semicolon at the end of statement, then it will not display the result in command window, so that's why you can't take the semicolon. Okay, then if I want to select the particular value, so what is the meaning of this? This is another one variable B, so it will select the value from matrix A, so is A 1, 2. So 1, 2 means what? 1, 2. In 1 means row number first, 2 means row number second, 3 means in first row the value number third, because in column number third, 1, 2, 3. So in the first row column number third, it will select third. Then 1, 4 is row number first and column number 4, it will select 4. Then row number second, so is this is row number second, in that it will select row number second and column number third, it will select 7. Again row number second and column number 4, so it will select 8 value. Okay, that's it. So these are the different ways to select the values, nothing else. You can also take as your own. Now there are different indexing matrices, means index complete row or column using the colon operator. If you want to select whole row, in that case you can take 1, so it will select first row. Can also add limit index matrix range, means it will select 1:2, means 1 to 2 rows, comma colon means all the values from the row number first and second. Okay, so initially what is this? Is a multidimensional array. So in that, this first thing is 1, 1 is nothing but row number first, column number first. Is the row number first, column number second, row number 1, column number 3rd, row number 1, column number 4. In that, second row, column first, second row, second column, second row, third column, second row, fourth column. Like this, third, fourth, and up to fourth column. So like that, you can select a particular row and particular column in any matrix, or also you can make the different arithmetic operation on that particular row and column as per your application. So this is all about the vectors and arrays. So I hope you understand what I have teach in this lecture number 3rd. So if you like this video, then you can share or subscribe my channel. If you don't like, then also give some suggestion, because I am new in this YouTube channel. So if you give some comment, then I can improve myself. So thank you everyone.